Okay, I'm gonna try to do this on the phone. I'm gonna do it from far away because I think it's gonna make some really cool sound because I'm in like this ravine, like hollow looking thing. I got some big trees. I wanna get down so I can get some wood out so I can have some cash flow because it took like a week to get moved here. So it slows things down. I'm just looking to get some stuff rolling. Give me some time to get in the back. This is as far as skids. But that tree right there is about 800 board foot. Hard to tell from here. This one here is about 1,000 board feet. It's big. Big red oaks. So I'm gonna do the back one first. I'm gonna try to bring it right straight at us. And then I'll do this one. And I'm gonna try to land the top like right here behind my head. So it's gonna be close, so just work with it. It's gonna be a little bit of a longer video. I'm sorry about that, but I like to change it up sometimes. Thank you.
Second one went perfect.
The first one, not so much. Whole top busted up out of it pretty bad. So, thanks for sticking around for that one. I'll walk you up here, I'll show you where it broke. I should have tried to get it to go a little more into the ditch, and maybe it would have. You'll see, there's this one limb. What was that? Maybe it would have let that limb fall down in this ravine or wash or whatever this is, and it wouldn't have broke as bad. But I mean, that tree's this big. It's just, there's really no steering them. Kind of got to go the way they want to go. Ain't a bad cut, I don't think. Yeah, but see, I got 30 feet of usable log. And then I might be able to chop something out of there, but it'll be blocking, you know, that upper bigger half. If I could have brought that top a little more over that way, maybe it would have went in that ditch, like that big arm there would have went down that ditch when it broke. But then I was going to wipe out that nice little young hard maple, and I didn't want to do that, but just kind of damage control. I got to top these.